How does the RX 570 perform in Star Citizen? This is the video. Plus, today, a bit of a discussion about the NVIDIA driver overhead discussion thing that's been going on recently. So we'll get into both of those. It's all in a series of trying to find the minimum spec GPU for Star Citizen, as well as just the minimum spec PC in general. So let's just get straight into the RX 570, and then we'll talk about the NVIDIA driver overhead. Let's get to the benchmarks. Let's go. This time, all the results are at 1080p, apart from the 3080. The 3080 doesn't really make any difference because even at 1440p, it's still CPU bottleneck, so the results will basically be the same. But we are targeting 1080p for the 570, so that's what we're going for. And it is a meaningful improvement over the 1050 Ti here in both systems. It's obviously GPU bottleneck there, as you can see. The i5 is performing as well as the 5900X. So yeah, that's a good start. Less of an impressive result here. You'd expect more of an uplift here. That is not a big game. 3 FPS, you'd expect those cars to be further apart. So that is a hint of what's to come. There's some strange results coming. Something potentially architecturally could be to do with this whole NVIDIA driver overhead. We'll get to that at the end. Very odd results here. The 1050 Ti beats the 570 on both systems, the i5 and the 5900X. Not really sure why. Again, we're gonna explore this a bit in a minute, but it's a strange result, not at all what we'd expect to see. Louisville now, and interestingly, the 1050 Ti on the 5900X at least is effectively ahead. It's not very much, but it is ahead. On the i5, they're really the same result. That's not much difference. This is partially to do with the section of this run that goes along the trains, and it's quite intensive GPU-wise, looking across the whole city, and the 570 is struggling hard there, really tanks low. Again, the 570 is not beating the 1050 Ti at all, despite, obviously, you can see the 3080, there is room here on the 5900X system for bigger results, for better results, but it's the same as the 1050 Ti. Quantum travel, not a massive increase, but an increase. That's better. I would say if you were averaging 24 in quantum travel, that's playable, whereas it's not particularly nice at 19, so getting better. Calliope with big weather effects, it's a straight loss to the 1050 Ti. The 570 is slow here, and there's just got to be something going on with these lower end AMD cards here, architecturally or something, that's just meaning they can't perform, because it shouldn't be this slow. Wally's Bar, a bit of an outlier with the i5 system here, not sure what's going on there, but effectively it's the same as the 1050 Ti, which we wouldn't expect. So let's get into some chat about all this. So first up, the RX 570 basically is a bust. It's no good. We had been looking for the minimum spec GPU, and this is not it. The 1050 Ti wasn't it. This is better in some results. In 1080p, it's better. And in some, it's worse. It doesn't make really much sense. If you look at all the benchmarks for this GPU, it shouldn't be performing this badly, which leads us on to our next topic. Now, a few weeks ago, Hardware Unboxed, the great YouTube channel, did a video all about NVIDIA driver overhead. And they were looking at, effectively, how in some scenarios in DX12 games, with a low-end CPU, you'd get worse performance with NVIDIA than you would with AMD. The actual video that you probably should watch, you should watch that, and I'll link that below, but the one you should really watch, especially if you really want to understand this, is this great video that they linked from Nerd Tech, who effectively goes through all the reasons why that is happening and why it is there. Let me try and summarize this video for you. I'll attempt it. It's quite complicated. You should actually just go and watch it, but I'll give it a go here. Back in the day, we're talking DirectX 11. And most games then, and actually up until quite recently, were pretty much single-threaded on the CPU side. What NVIDIA did, they moved their scheduler for the GPU to tell it what order to do draw calls and things like that. They moved it from the hardware and they moved it into their driver, so it became a software scheduler. So that moving into driver meant that they actually it uses up more CPU resources, but in DX11 single-threaded games, especially back in the day, it meant that they actually got a huge performance boost, because often what would happen would be the game would be just running on the single thread. Once that single thread has been used up, can't work, do any more work, it's fully maxed out 100%, you're stuck. Whereas what NVIDIA managed to do was to use their software scheduler, part of the driver, to divert some of this GPU work, some of the render work, to different threads on the CPU. So say you had a quad-core CPU, rather than it all being on the one CPU thread, it would be able to be moved to the different threads or cores. I hope you're with me so far. So what that meant was NVIDIA could see big gains in some games that were DX11 single-threaded. How that relates to us is that Star Citizen is still currently a DX11 game, and they're obviously this year potentially moving across to Vulkan, to their DX 12 12th gen renderer implementation. So that is coming, and that will change this story slightly. But what it really means for us is that although Star Citizen is still pretty well threaded, as in they've talked a lot about how they've improved CryEngine, which is what it's based on, they've moved things like physics rendering, they've moved a lot, and there's a lot going on in Star Citizen. You've got AI, everything. It's not a single threaded game. If you try to play Star Citizen with one or two cores, we've done this testing before, even up to probably like six or six with 12 threads, it will improve, it will scale with the more cores you get. However, it is still possible, because it's a DX11 game, that something is going on here, and why we're seeing some of these sorts of results, there's something going on in terms of the GPU rendering, which is holding back the AMD cards, these low-end cards. They just don't perform as well, it seems, as Nvidia cards. So we're almost in the opposite scenario to what Hardware Unboxed were originally looking at. They were looking at DX12 games and why they'd see better performance with AMD. Well, with Star Citizen, we're in the reverse of that. We're a DX11 game currently, and it looks as though there's some sort of better performance for lower end Nvidia GPUs, because this software scheduler, this is all speculation, mind you, but there seems to be something on there. The RX 570 shouldn't be slower than the 1070 in most scenarios, and it doesn't make much sense that it would be this poor in some areas. So that is the rough explanation. I'll put some stats up here on the screen. Let me have a quick look. So you can see here on Area 18, the plaza, a big difference in GPU load between the Nvidia card and the AMD card. They're both maxing out the GPU, and they're both getting effectively the same frames, but there is a big jump. We're nearly actually maxing out a i5 8400 here. And if you've played Star Citizen for a while and looked at your CPU kind of usage as you've gone, you'll know how hard it is to actually get anywhere near 100%. So we've got six core CPU, that there's a big difference in the CPU load, and that is likely down to this Nvidia driver overhead, but potentially is also helping performance in this DX11 game. And then let's move across to Calliope, which is heavily GPU bottlenecked. And again, you can see a big difference in the CPU load between those two cards and between the two manufacturers. So that is effectively the Nvidia driver overhead in action. And there's other, I could show this on the different stats, but it's effectively the same story. And you obviously could argue, oh well, it could just be the server, but it is consistent, this. And I'm fairly convinced that what Hardware Unboxed found is what we're seeing here. So yeah, I'd really encourage you to go and watch those other videos, the Hardware Unboxed one and the NerdTech one. Really interesting, do a much better job than me of explaining it. But that's been this one. If you've liked it, give it a like. If you like this sort of stuff in general, this more technical look at Star Citizen, give me a subscribe, I would love that. And also, come and follow me on Twitch, where when I get to 100,000 Twitch followers, I get a tattoo, Chris Roberts' face on my foot. See you soon. Bye.